I am an alien from Mars. Peekaboo!
Oh, hello and welcome to another episode of the Crazy News Reporter. I'm the Crazy News Reporter. And today, we have some very, very special segments just for you. And 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 you. Okay, let's fix the hair. Our first special segment is all about Mars. Have you heard of Mars? You've probably heard of Mars. Mars, like Earth, where we live, is a planet. Ask your parents. They'll tell you what Mars is. Thanks, parents! Anyways, Mars, the fourth planet from the sun, our next-door neighbor, because we live on Earth, the third planet from the sun, Mars has a very special guest. Its name is Perseverance. It's like a robot car that was designed by humans here on Earth, and we shipped it off to Mars, one planet away, to see if there was any life on Mars. So, in this very special segment, your boy, Franky Baby, is gonna tell us all about everything he's been seeing on Mars. Your boy, Franky Baby?
Hey, how you doing? It's your boy, Franky Baby. I'm walking here on Mars, as you can see. It's a red planet. We're here. We're coming to you live, except it's a recording. You know, we're here for you, providing you with the news about Perseverance, or Perseverance, whatever that crazy news reporter said, told you about. We're out here. We're on Mars. We're looking for signs of life, signs of water, and you know, as soon as we find anything, we're gonna tell you. You know, there's not much of an atmosphere. I'm not gonna tell you that there's not, cause there is, but it's negligible. All right, look that word up, negligible. Put that up on the screen, okay? Negligible. You know, they did it again. The folks at NASA and Jet Propulsion Labs. You know, they made the sky crane, made it come down. You know, they did it again. You know, they did it once and it was too nice. They had to do it twice, you know. Between you and me, I'm here on my own mission. I hitched a ride with NASA, okay? But now, I'm looking for aliens, okay? We're looking for big, tall, skinny ones. We're looking for little microscopic guys. I got my microscope, you know. We're gonna scope it out here, all right? So if there are any aliens here hiding, I'm gonna find them, okay? And if you know of any aliens hiding, you tell me, okay? You tell me. Do you know of any aliens that are hiding? You see any aliens today that are hiding? Huh? Because they're hiding from me, okay? And I'm gonna find them. And I'm gonna befriend them, okay? That's what I'm here for. I'm here, you know, searching for friends on Mars. Cause, you know, Earth, I don't know what's going on over there with you guys, okay? But anyway, I'm gonna keep my eyes out. I'm gonna tell you what I see in the field. And, you know, you tell me. You tell me. You see any aliens hiding? I could use some friends. That's it for your boy Franky Baby. Over and out. Yeah.
Shh. It's a dance segment. Now, Uncle Franky and your Tante Sarah live on the top floor of an apartment building, which means there are people that live right downstairs. So your Uncle Franky and Tante Sarah try not to use loud footsteps. We're going to practice our ability to shh while we dance. Well, get up! Let's dance!
Make two fists in front of your belly button.
Now draw a big oval starting at your belly button and pushing out as far as you can. Bounce your knees to the rhythm of the music and let's groove! This next move is called the upside down ladybug. So lay on floor, put your feet and your hands in the air, and shake it like you just don't care. Next, we have a move I like to call the cool chicken. Grab your favorite pair of sunnies and move your head back and forth like a chicken. Take your arms, put them in your armpits as if you were doing the chicken dance, and then move those arms on down, cause baby, we are cool! Our last dance move needs no introduction. It's the wacky waving inflatable arm flailing tube man! Be careful now, don't hit your siblings!
It's time for Talk of the Town. And now, your hosts, Bethany Fiddlesticks and Bartholomew Jones.
I can't wait to see your art. Let's talk about art. Let's talk about art. Last time on the Crazy News Reporter, I asked you to take all of your scrap pieces of construction paper and make a masterpiece. And boy, oh boy, did you make masterpieces. Now, in this masterpiece, I appreciate how those yellow scraps of paper are extending past the blue and reaching out to the audience's soul. Lovely. And here, the use of the single piece of pink scrap paper against the purple and the black contrasting background. Ooh, this gives me 90s vibes and reminds me of my childhood. Thank you, artist. Look at that contrast with the striking yellow background. The intricate details shining through the dark purples and the vibrant greens. Oh, and that perfect little heart in the corner. Oh, I see you, little heart, and I love it. Well, hello. What do we have here? My, a queen made of scrap pieces of paper with rubies in her crown. Isn't she lovely? And as you can see, right here is mine. It says, hello. I also received some art from the week previously, where you mixed two animals into one. This week for art, we're going to make some planets. You will need a coffee filter, markers, and a spray bottle full of water. First, flatten one coffee filter onto your work surface. Then, pick out two or three markers you'd like to use for your planet. Then draw shapes or stripes or whatever you want and scribble them in carelessly. This doesn't need to be perfect. In fact, it's better if it's not perfect. You see all the spaces I'm leaving uncolored? You can do the same. Once you're done, place your coffee filter on a surface that you don't mind if it'll get wet. Then spray away and wait. You'll start to notice that those colors spread out and migrate to the spaces you didn't color. They kind of mix together. Now, lift up your coffee filter and stick it to the window. Once it's dry, it'll fall off the window, and there you have it, a planet!
Hello, and welcome to Defining Madness. I'm your host, Lester Something.
And I'm Cola Corvin. And this is Defining Madness.
Here on Defining Madness, we bring meaning to the words that don't have any meaning, that is. We define words that don't have meaning. We give definitions to words we made up.
Our first word for the day is thrompet.
Thrompet. To yeet with vigor. When you need it to get there, and you need it to get there now, don't just ship it. Thromp it. Thromp it.
Our next word for the day is qwee-pweekled.
Qwee-pweekled. To take out the trash. Hey, little Johnny, will you qwee-pweekled?
Thank you, Lester. Our next word is dwoozock.
Dwoozock, an Eastern European duck that answers to Timothy. Hey, who's that dwoozock over there? Oh, you mean Timothy? Yes, that's the dwoozock I was talking about. I wasn't aware that he went by Timothy. Dwoozock. And that's all that we have time for today. I'm Lester Something.
And I'm Cola Corvin.
And this has been
Defining Madness. Well, I had the most fun afternoon hanging out with you. I love you very, very, very much. And I'll see you next time on The Crazy News Reporter.
I'm Lester Something.
And I'm Cola Corvin.
We just won't look at each other.
I know.
Hey, who's that dwoozock over there? Hey. Thank you.
What did you found? Oh, that's good.